Back to Moulsecoomb Primary School and the proposed academisation of it. I'm here with some parents, so you know best. So we've got Eureka Hoffman, and we've got Natasha Ide. You've both got kids in school, haven't you? Moulsecoomb Primary School. So should we start off with maybe Eureka first, just give us an idea, an overview of what's going on at Moulsecoomb Primary School?
Well, Moulsecoomb Primary School had an Ofsted rating in April, back in April, May, of being inadequate. And soon followed an academisation order from the Department for Education, and we are fighting against it because we don't believe that Moulsecoomb Primary School is inadequate. We believe it has improved since then. It already showed in the Ofsted report that Key Stage 1 has improved. The last SATS result showed
Key Stage 2.
Key Stage 2 has improved as well, and we think that academisation order needs to be revoked.
Yeah. So, Natasha, tell us about your experience at the Moulsecoomb Primary School and your position on it.
So, I mean, I love Moulsecoomb Primary School. I've lived there all my life. I went there, my parents went there, and now my children go there. And I just think it would be so devastating for the community to lose the school, because we are a community and we're a tight community, and the last thing we want is for this to be taken over by an academy and then our children lose out on all the funding for their education. It'd just be devastating. It's something that we're really against, and we will keep fighting to make them walk away.
And you're clearly very organised. You've got a campaign, Hands Off Moulsecoomb Primary School, haven't you? So tell us a bit about that. Maybe give back to Eureka first.
We have massive support from all unions involved, which is the NEU, Unison and GMB.
Yeah.
They help us organising things, but we also have a smaller parents group, and we write letters, collect signatures.
We're in the playground nearly every day, handing out information letters. We've done digging dirt on the trusts that have been named to let all the parents know the stuff that we found out. We literally are on that playground nearly every day. We was out there yesterday. We were still giving out more information. And then because strike's been announced now, we're even now in the process of sorting out childcare and
for working parents,
parents that are not going to be able to get the childcare for their children, so that they don't have to lose a day's pay, so that it doesn't affect the families that are going to struggle. That we're all just staying together as a community and trying to help where we can.
And when is that strike date coming? Because I know 21st. We've spoken to the National Education Union about that as well, NEU.
Yeah, it's the 21st.
21st
day of strike.
Of November,
yes.
Yeah. The first day, yeah.
Yeah, so what else are you doing to try and kind of revoke the order? Because the only way around this is really to revoke it, isn't it? So you need, that's the Secretary of State, isn't it? Which is currently Gavin Williamson.
Gavin Williamson. And we've
collected
1,000 signatures for our pledge cards.
Then we've done our pledge cards. Me and Uli have been doing stalls on the weekends, like outside Aldi on the Lewis Road and places like that. And we've just been getting, that's what I mean, the amount of the community support, not even parents from the school, and even teachers from other schools. Like some of the conversations we've had doing the stalls, it's so nice and warming to hear.
So let's talk a bit about that then, because this is, maybe Ofsted haven't looked into that, because this is a key thing, isn't it?
Particularly
kids that have had trauma, past trauma, sensory needs.
Autism.
Really important, aren't they? So why is Moulsecoomb Primary School good at that?
I think one point that really struck me when I first saw the school is the amazing ground. They've got possibilities there that other schools in Brighton have not got. They've got a massive amount of land, they've got huts there, the children themselves build, they've got a fish pond,
they've
chicken,
got allotments,
they've got allotments, they've got a lot of stuff going on that is for, like for example, kinesthetic learners, brilliant, touch and feel, be in nature. This is quite a nurturing school.
They've just improved the library as well, and that's amazing.
Yes, and if children struggle, there is nurture groups to help them through situations. Yeah. There is a play therapist coming in, working with children.
That's critical, isn't it?
That
really
is critical.
They do a lot of work. They do a lot of work around children with needs. I know that when my eldest boy was there, he was having a lot of struggle with friendships and just like being around and communicating, and they done amazing work with him. He used to go to what they called the Lighthouse at the time, and they get like small groups of children, and they work on them being, so they sit in the middle in a circle, and then they all have to say something positive. And it improved his relationship with other pupils in the school quite a bit. I mean, he still struggles now, and he'll always struggle in life, but it helped him a lot, doing the nurturing side of things and doing the lighthouse at Moulsecoomb. They work with the children.
And also, if you are a child with trauma, you don't want that disruption either, do you? Because this is going to cause disruption for their kids, which is the most important thing.
We've got fantastically qualified staff that are very good, with especially special needs children.
Yeah.
And most academies let go of a lot of staff, make class sizes bigger.
Yeah.
Employ unqualified
staff, which I think could be devastating for children.
So what's next then? I know you've got the strike day. What's next for the Hands Off Moulsecoomb campaign?
So we are looking at the next process would be we will be protesting, and we will keep protesting outside any businesses necessary. And also we've looked, because the trust that are announced, their business is quite far away from where we live, so it'd be quite impossible to go and protest outside his specific business, which is what we wanted to do. So the next step would be, which we really wouldn't want to have to do because we wouldn't want it for our children, but the next step would be that we will protest outside their other school.
Yeah.
And it would be a last
Which is in, is that in Shoreham?
Lancing.
Lancing, yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
But again, we will do what we need to do to keep this going and to make them walk away. They're not welcome.
To make
them
understand, because the ballot, the current ballot clearly showed 96% of people that have been asked, and it was a turnout of 61%, are not for an academy walking in. So parents clearly said no, and to be quite honest, statistically, that has more pull than a Brexit.
Yeah. Right. So next steps are you're protesting. You've had support from, I know, the local MP, Lloyd Russell Moyle, who I'll be speaking to later today as well. So do you think the election, that might have an impact? I mean, obviously, if the Labour Party get in at the next election, they're against the academy. So that would, I would have thought that would probably end the process. Yeah. But
let's not get our hopes up and not jump to conclusions before it happens.
We're happy to still fight this off ourselves.
Yes.
And we're quite still
determined.
And we are still strongly believe that, as much as a lot of the parents, because of the letters that have been being sent out from the trust through the school, it's making a lot of parents have already inquired at other schools to take their children out because they don't want it to be an academy.
Yes.
But there's also been a lot of parents that are saying that if it stays as a normal school, you know, that they're all willing to come together and do what we can to help keep improving.
Yeah.
I think if there was talk, because our first strike day is on the 21st of November, if the trust does not walk away, there will be more strike days following, possibly in January, which will be quite a tricky time financially for a lot of families after Christmas.
Yeah.
So we will have strike care, we will set up and hopefully run a strike kitchen for the children that are on preschool meals.
Yes.
That depend on these meals. Yeah.
So we're doing what we can to help the parents as much as we can.
And we support ourselves.
But we are only
on
parents ourselves,
well.
So it does get quite difficult. And sometimes there's just things that are out of our control that we can't get that done ourselves. We're only parents.
Yeah.
You know, when we looked at doing the strike childcare, we've looked into so many different places where we could hold it to cater for the children and still have a kitchen to be able to cook for them. And it's just getting quite difficult, isn't it? You know, our local church and that have been amazing, and they're happy to let us use the church for strike days for the children's care and stuff.
Yep.
But it's just, the wider community, if they could help support us more when it comes to the strike kitchen and things, that'd be great.
And how can they do that? So
there's a link, there's an email, isn't there, that they can email to for donations for like just dried food, like pastas and sauces.
And that's on your, have you got a website?
There's a lot of links.
I think the best way would be to get via the Hands Off Moulsecoomb Primary School Facebook page.
So Hands Off Moulsecoomb, and then via that, people
via
can,
that, all
people
the other
can
links
get in
and
touch
stuff.
With us.
Okay. Eureka, Natasha, thanks for coming today. All the best
Thank
of the campaign.
You
obviously make very good parents and you're very committed. So it's good to see.
Thank you very much.
Thank
you, Mark.